السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1158 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on Surah Hashr, chapter number 59, which was revealed in Madinah Munawwara and surrounding. This surah comprises 24 verses, and this is part 64 of our Quranic series on the virtues of the noble Quran. Almighty Allah Jalla Wala mentions, وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam brings and commands you, that you must accept and practice on. وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُ. And whatever Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibits you from, you must abstain and refrain from that. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ and fear Allah. In the next three verses, Surah 59, verses 8, 9, and 10, Almighty Allah Jalla Wala speaks of the Sahaba, لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ الَّذِينَ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ. Those Muhajirin migrants who were expelled from their homes in Makkah Mukarramah, they left everything there and they did all this for the love and pleasure of Almighty Allah. Almighty Allah calls them أُولَٰئِكَ مُصَادِقُونَ. They are the truthful ones. So how can ever a person, whether he is a Shia or anybody else, go and condemn the Sahaba and curse them when Allah says they are truthful? Then in Surah 59 verse 9, Almighty Allah speaks about the Ansar. And remember, Hubbul Ansar min al Iman, to love the Ansar is part of Iman, is mentioned in Bukhari Sharif. They were the people, يُحِبُّونَ مَنْ هَاجَرَ إِلَيْهِمْ. They loved those people who migrated towards them. And وَيُؤْثِرُونَ عَلَى أَنفُسِهِمْ. They gave them preference over themselves. وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَصَاصًا. Although they themselves were in dire straits and in big need, in great need. The third group, that's me and you who came after them, what must we say? رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَالْإِخْوَانِنَا الَّذِينَ سَبَقُونَا بِالْإِيمَانِ. Oh Allah, forgive us, forgive our brothers, sisters who passed away before us with Iman. وَلَا تَجَلْ فِي قُلُوبِنَا غِلَّا. Do not place in our hearts malice, hatred, rancor. For those people who have Iman, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. So this is the dua we should make. Hazrat Zainul Abideen, that is the son of Sayyidina Hussein radiallahu ta'ala, when a person came to him and was condemning some Sahaba and companions and students of Nabi alayhi salam, he asked him, are you the Muhajirin? He said, no. Are you from Ansar? He said, no. He said, you're not from the third category as well. Man sabbaha ula falaysa minha ula. If you speak bad and curse Sahaba, you can't belong to the third category. The reference is in Tafsir Qurtubi. Similarly, Almighty Allah Jalla Wala speaks of the Jews, تَحْسَبُهُمْ جَمِيعًا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. You think that they are united, but their hearts are fragmented, as we can see today in the political landscape. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ قَوْمٌ لَا يَعْقِلُونَ. Because they don't have true understanding. They will have very shallow understanding. Then Almighty Allah teaches us, think about what you are sending forth for the year after. وَلْتَنْذُرُ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Fear Almighty Allah is mentioned twice in this one verse. And don't be like those people who forgot Allah. We don't make zikr of Allah. We don't follow the obedience of Allah. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. Then Allah makes you forget yourself. You forget your very purpose. And then they join Hizb al-Shaytan. And thereafter Almighty Allah speaks about the glory of the Quran. لَوْ أَنْزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِئًا مُتَصَدِّئًا مِنْ خَشْيَةٍ. Hypothetically, if the Quran Sharif was revealed on a mountain, it should be blasted to smithereens out of the fear of Allah. The last three verses are very important about Tawheed, the oneness, uniqueness, authority, sovereignty, majesty of Almighty Allah. هُوَ اللَّهُ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّهُ. The last three verses of Surah 59, so this is verse 22, 23, 24. So we should read it after first Fajr after Maghrib, and Almighty Allah will protect us. But how do we read it? A'udhu billahi sami'il alim minash shaitanir rajim. Once, again, second time, A'udhu billahi sami'il alim minash shaitanir rajim. And then third time, A'udhu billahi sami'il alim minash shaitanir rajim. And then we read, Huwallahu alladhi, once 70,000 angels will come and protect us. Open Tafsir Ibn Kathir and various compilations. May Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala shower His special mercy upon us and envelope us with His mercy and Hifadat. Barakallahu Fik. Assalamu Alaikum wa Rahmatullahi wa Barakatuh.